I'm Janet Davis. I'm also Whitman's founding computer scientist. My research area is human-computer interaction.
I don't think you can really think about artificial intelligence outside of the human context in which those tools are going to be used. What are tools without a person using them? They're nothing.
And I think there are big questions still not answered about how tools like ChatGPT can help us improve the quality of our work or lead better lives. Clearly, having ChatGPT write an essay for you isn't that. But there are some interesting questions about augmented intelligence that's kind of a foil to artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence suggests that we can build computer systems that replace people. Augmented intelligence is the idea that computer systems can help people do their work better. And I think it's a very big difference in philosophy. There's been this history in computing of new tools kind of raising the level of abstraction. In the 1950s and 60s, like, you programmed computers directly by physically wiring things together. Then there was the invention of machine language, which let instructions be stored on punch cards, so that instead of having to program, you know, wire the computer together, you just gave it a series of instructions. And then I believe Grace Hopper was among those who worked on the invention of the assembler. So you took code in an assembly language with instructions like move, store, add, multiply, and translated those human-readable instructions into zeros and ones. And then was the invention of the compiler, so we could write in even higher level programming languages. And if you look at GitHub Copilot or GPT-3 as an automated code generator, it's like, you know, we've had automated code generators for 20 years or more. This is just raising the level of abstraction one step more, where you describe what you want and it generates the code for you. One big discussion that's been happening among educators is, well, how do we raise our standards so that a computer can't pass the class? One possibility is, well, we need to raise our standards so that you can't pass a course by turning in text that could have been written by a computer. One thing I worry about is that seems like kind of an arms race. Does that mean that we now expect students to do higher and higher level work in order to pass the course? That doesn't seem right. Another way to look at it is, if we look at ChatGPT-3 as kind of an opportunity for augmented intelligence, that suggests that what we really should be doing is actually teaching students how to work with these tools and how to use these tools to improve the quality of their work. The problem is, these tools are brand new and we have no idea how to do that. Can we teach students to do something we know how to do ourselves? I'm considering ungrading, which is a grading philosophy that emphasizes student learning over performance. What process did you go through to get there, and what did you learn through that process? And if you make a computer do the work for you, well, you can't reflect on that because you didn't do it. You didn't learn anything. That doesn't necessarily exclude collaborating with a computer, because you have to think critically about the work that the computer is giving you and how does it meet or not meet the goals of the assignment. How can you add your own ideas? How can you fill in the gaps, correct factual errors, rewrite in your own voice? I think there's some promise there. I don't know what to do with it yet, but it's kind of exciting. I think ChatGPT is both exciting and terrifying. It's amazing what it can do. As a college student writing my first text generation system, I never would have dreamed that a computer system would generate such plausible looking text. I never dreamed that a computer system would be able to understand our natural language prompts to generate the kind of text that we want it to generate. And I do think that there are amazing possibilities for ChatGPT as a provocateur. The terrifying part, of course, is people using ChatGPT to replace human thought. It's a computer system. There's no mind there.
there might be an illusion of a mind, but there is no mind. It's following rules in a way that we can't possibly understand or explain, but at its heart, it's still just following rules. I think the thing that scares me the most is people using ChatGPT as a way to avoid thinking. And maybe even worse than that, relying on ChatGPT because what it writes seems authoritative, but not thinking critically about whether it's true or whether it's right. That is, I think, the thing that scares me the most, is that text generated by something like ChatGPT could kind of infiltrate our thinking and contribute to misinformation.